Internal Revenue Service, IRS Tax News. Expanded tax benefits help individuals and businesses give to charity in 2021. COVID tax tip 2021-143, September 28th, 2021. Recent legislation includes several provisions that help individuals and businesses who give to charity. There's a link to giving to charity here. The new law generally extends for temporary tax changes through the end of 2021. Here's an overview of these changes. Deduction for individuals who don't itemize. So normally, when you think about giving to charity, it's usually an itemized deduction. But recently, they increased the standard deduction, so there's really less people that are itemizing in general, which in general is a kind of a good thing because they're trying to simplify the code. And typically, people that are itemizing are typically going to be more well-off people that are getting the benefit from itemizing. So it'd be kind of easier to just have a standard deduction. But as you do that, then all the little things that are in the itemized deductions that they still want to keep around may be floating over to the non-itemized area, which is kind of what happened with the charitable deduction. So you still have that itemized component if you do itemize, meaning if you have itemized deductions greater than the standard deductions, then those charitable deductions in that area could be beneficial to you. But they also pulled some of it over out of the itemized section so you can get a benefit from them, even if you're taking, in essence, the standard deduction, although it's going to be limited in that area. So that's kind of the general idea. They've also made some changes, in essence, to the limits in terms of how much you can give to charity within the itemized. So let's go into it in a bit more detail. Usually taxpayers who take the standard deduction cannot deduct their charitable contributions. The law now permits taxpayers to claim a limited deduction on their 2021 federal income tax returns for cash contributions they made to certain qualified charitable organizations. These taxpayers, including married individuals filing separate returns, can claim a deduction of up to $300 for cash contributions to qualifying charities during 2021. The maximum deduction is $600 for married individuals filing joint returns. And I think at one time it was only $300 no matter what your status was, so it makes sense that it's $600 now. So it's severely limited compared to the itemized deduction, but at least you've got something there as well. So they got the cash donations. Most cash donations made to charity qualify for the deduction. However, there are some exceptions. Cash contributions that are not tax deductible include those made to a supporting organization intended to help establish or maintain a donor-advised fund, carried forward from prior years, made to most private foundations, made to charitable remainder trusts. These exceptions also apply to taxpayers who itemize their deductions. Cash contributions include those made by check, credit card, or debit card, as well as unreimbursed out-of-pocket expenses in connection with volunteer services to a qualifying charitable organization. Cash contributions don't include the value of volunteer services, securities, household items, or other property. 100% limit on eligible cash contributions made by taxpayers who itemized deductions in 2021. So now we're back to the normal itemizing section. So if you do itemize, meaning you have itemized deductions over the standard deduction, then you may get the benefit from the charitable deductions as normal in the itemized area, as it had been before this kind of change. And you might have a bigger limit in terms of how much you can put in. In other words, there's usually a cap, like an AGI or income cap kind of limitation that they extended. And so here's that area. So taxpayers who itemize can generally claim a deduction for charitable contributions to qualifying organizations. The deduction is typically limited to 20% to 60% of their adjusted gross income and varies depending on the type of contribution and the type of charity. The law now allows taxpayers to apply up to 100% of their AGI, their adjusted gross income. So in essence, their income, right? You are limited to how much portion of your income you can put into charity. Now they raised it up to 100% in essence of the AGI income. So for calendar year 2021, qualified contributions. So for 2021, so qualified contributions are cash contributions to qualifying charitable organizations. The percent limit is not automatic. The taxpayers must choose to take the new limit for any qualified cash contributions. Otherwise, the usual limit applies. The taxpayers' other allowed charitable contributions deductions reduce the maximum amount allowed under this election. So eligible individuals must make their elections on their 2021 Form 1040 or Form 1040 SR. So you could say, do you want to take that 100% or not? In some instances, if you took 100% of your AGI, you know, you might actually want to roll some of the charitable contributions forward because the taxes might be higher in the following year. So in some cases, you might end up saying, well, I don't want to take 100% of my charitable contributions, even though I gave more in this particular year, possibly because more people are in need, or I felt it was a year that it was good for giving or whatever. And you still might want to roll some of it forward because the fact that your income dropped by so much due to giving the charity means that you're at a lower adjusted gross income. And because we have a progressive tax system, maybe subject to a lower tax bracket and so on. So in any case, corporate tax increased to 25% of taxable income. The law now permits C corporations to apply an increased corporate limit of 25% of taxable income for charitable cash contributions made to eligible charities during calendar year 2021. The increased limit is not automatic. A C corporation must choose the increased corporate limit on a contribution-by-contribution basis. Increased limit on amounts deductible by businesses for certain donated food inventory. So now we got food donations. So businesses donating food inventory that are eligible for the existing enhanced deduction qualify for increased deduction limits. For contributions made in 2021, the limit is increased to 25%. For C corporations, the 25% limit is based on their taxable income. For other businesses, including sole proprietorships, partnerships, and S corporations, the limit is based on their total net income for the year. A social method for computing the enhanced deduction continues to apply, as do food quality standards and other requirements. So there'll be links to this in the description if you want to read into it in more detail.